His servants will say, you know what? Utruku azwaja. Let him be now with his wife. Let him be at home. So now, the hadith states, فَإِذَنْ حَوْرَى مِنَ الْحُورِ الْإِينَ جَالِسَةٌ عَلَى سَرِيرِ مُلْكِيَا. There will be a Huri'een sitting on her throne. This is the queen. And when she will be wearing 70 dresses again, the same hadith states the same thing. And the beauty of her thigh will be visible. And you know what? When he looks at her, she is so beautiful, that the hadith states, you know, you've heard love at first sight, haven't you? It doesn't really work in the dunya. In the akhirah, this is real. You know how long he'll look at her for? He won't know what's hit him. You know, a woman so beautiful, can it be? He will look at her for 40 years. 40 years, you know, he won't know what's hit him. He will, you know, his eyes, you know, like as if he's in coma. He'll just look one direction, and I'm assuming his mouth will be open. What's this? Now, this is where I want my sisters just to put the headphones on. Because this part of the bayan, when I tell them to take the headphones off, that's when they listen to the next part of the bayan. But this part of the bayan is only for the men. Yeah. Now, you're thinking, you know what? How beautiful can she be? Now, how beautiful can a woman be? Yeah? You know what? You've got to look at the maker. فَتَبَارَكَ اللَّهُ أَحْسُنُ الْخَالِقِينَ. Blessed Allah, the best of creators. You know, when Allah makes something, then believe me, He can make something. And these Huri'eens are so beautiful, that Rasulullah ﷺ in one hadith said, لو أن بعض بنانها بدا لغلب ضوءه ضوء الشمس والقمر. That, you know, just her fingertip, if it was ever to become visible in this dunya, you know, the nur, the light, the gleam, call it what you want, of her fingertip, it's so bright, so beautiful, that that would overpower the light of the sun and moon put together. This is just her fingertip. You need to get there to believe it, don't you guys? You know, it's all right saying subhanallah here. Get there. It's going to get better, believe me. Don't be disappointed. لو أن شعرها بدت لملأت ما بين المشرق والمغرب من طيب ريحها. You know, if some of her hair were to become visible, Rasulullah ﷺ said, you know, the fragrance, the sweet smell coming from her hair would fill the entire dunya with a sweet smell. Better than your head and shoulders. Yeah? Or your timoti. Yeah? This is what you call shampoo. The entire dunya from the east and west would begin to smell beautiful because of the fragrance just coming from their hair. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, you know, they're sweet. They don't give you a hard time. So sweet that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, كَيْلَوْ أَنَّ حَوْرَى بَسَقَتْ فِي سَبْأَةِ أَبْحُرٍ لَعُذِبَتِ الْبِحَارِ مِنْ عُذُوبَةِ فَمِهَا. If she were to spit once inside the salty water of the seven oceans, then the water of the seven oceans would become sweet as a result of the sweetness of her mouth. You know, when she glorifies the Almighty Allah, here, you know, when Tina Turner is glorifying the shaitan, what happens? All of a sudden your bodies begin to move with simply is the best. You know, when she glorifies the Almighty Allah, not only will your bodies be moving, the hadith states, لَمْ يَبْقَ فِي الْجَنَّةِ شَجَرَةٌ إِلَّا وَرَدَّتْ. That even the trees in Jannah will begin to move and shake. And when she smiles, some of you have probably never received a smile at home. You know, it's unfair, because you've probably never given anything in return either. When she smiles, nur comes out of her mouth. When she smiles at her husband, Nur comes out of the mouth, and this nur rises in paradise, and everyone sees it. You know, once our mother Umm Salama radiallahu ta'ala, Allah elevate her ranks in paradise, asked a few questions with regards to the Hurayn. And you know, from this hadith of Rasulullah, seriously, you can tell how much patience she had. So she asked Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you know what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran with regards to this creation of Allah, Hurayn, that this is the term that Allah uses to describe them. What does it mean, Hurayn? So Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, it means that these women have big, white, beautiful, lustrous eyes. She says, Ya Rasulullah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran says with regards to them, كَأَنَّهُنَّ الْيَاقُوتُ وَالْمَرْجَانِ, that they're like the ruby and coral stone. What is Allah referring to? So Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, you know, in purity, these women and in beauty are like those precious stones which are inside the shells, which are untouched. Nobody's ever touched them. How pure and how beautiful those stones are. This is how beautiful and pure the Hurayn are. She then asked, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that Allah says in the Quran, Khayratun Hisan. He describes them, Khayrat and Hisan. What does this mean? So Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Khayrat, Khayratul Akhlaq. That their character is very good. You know, they're not throwing pans and plates at their husbands. By nature, they're beautiful and their faces are absolutely beautiful. So Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was then asked, Ya Rasulullah, Allah says in the Quran, كَأَنَّهُنَّ بَيْضٌ مَكْنُونَ. They are like as if they were delicate, closely guarded. What does this mean? So Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explained that in softness and gentleness, the skin inside of an egg, right next to the shell, how delicate that piece of skin is, this is how delicate, tender and soft the Hurayn are inside paradise. You know what, after this she asked the $1 million question. Now is the time my sister can take off their headphones. She asked, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أَنِسَاءُ الدُّنْيَا أَفْضَلْ أَمِ الْحُورِ الْإِينَ, are the women of dunya superior or the women of paradise more superior? And you were thinking, you know what, you've got rid. You were sad guys. What? London's a sad place. The Bradfordians would never think like that. We carry our wives. So you know what, she asked the $1 million question. Obviously Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa praising the Hurayn, you know, verse after verse after verse. So she wants to ask the $1 million question. And she said, Ya Rasulullah, who is more superior? So Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa said, نِسَاءُ الدُّنْيَا أَفْضَلْ مِنَ الْحُورِ الْإِينَ كَفَضْلِ الزِّحَارَةِ أَلَى الْبِتَانَ, that the women of the dunya will be more superior than the Hurayn, just like the upper garment of a quilt is better than the inner garment of the quilt. So now she's got the answer that she was looking for. By the grace of Allah, I've saved many heart attacks today. Many heart attacks. You know, from this my sisters need to learn, look how much regard Allah has for them. How much regard Allah has for the believing women. Before Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came, what was a woman? You know, in the entire world, even in the Western world, they were still debating whether she's a human being. They were still debating whether she was a human being. And in the land of Arabia, they were burying them alive. And this is when Allah, Messenger, declared, Allah said in the Quran, وَلَهُنَّ مِثْلُ الَّذِي عَلَيْهِنَّ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ, just as men have rights, the women have also rights. And he elevated their ranks in the dunya. And you know what? In spite of the fact that Allah is the best of creators, and Allah has created this creation, the Hurayn, he didn't let them down in the Akhirah. That even in the Akhirah, in spite of this great creation of Allah, these bandiya, these servants of Allah, will be far superior to this creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even in Jannah, Allah has elevated them. So now she's got the answer that she was looking for. She wanted to hear more. As women like to do, they love it when you tell them how beautiful they are. And so you should. That's the least that you can do. So she said, Ya Rasulullah, وَمِمَّا ذَاتْ. How will they be more superior? How is it that the women of Jannah are more superior to the women of paradise? So Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, بِصَلَاتِهِنَّ وَصِيَامِهِنَّ وَإِبَادَتِهِنَّ اللَّهِ. Because of their fasting, because of their worshipping and prostrating before Allah, because of their reciting the Quran, because of their giving their zakat and sadaqah, it is as a result of this, they are far superior to the women of paradise. And don't be disappointed, my young friend. Jamila will not be like she is here. Now you're thinking, oh my God, I don't have a choice in the matter. I've been doing all this and I've still got Jamila here. Jamila is not going to be like this, my young friend. Albasallahu wajuhahu nur. Her face, them looks will disappear. Wajuhahu nur. Allah will place nur on her face. This is how beautiful she will be.